tribute to India's soldiers. It's 20 years of our victory at Kargil this week, but many families and India paid a heavy price with the loss of their loved ones. Tonight, we remember our Kargil heroes.
My company's success kind of was ye dil mange more. The guys were so highly charged up that they're wanting that some more mangas should have been there and we would have got the more chaps.
He was the bravest of the brave, whose slogan ye dil mange more defined the spirit of some of India's bravest sons, soldiers who fought some of the most intense infantry battles since the Second World War. For his bravery, Vikram Batra was honored with the Param Vir Chakra. At the height of the Kargil War, the NDTV team met the young captain just days before he perished, fighting to liberate the impossible point 4875 in the Kargil Heights. His men knew him as Sher Shah, and the enemy had heard of this name as well.
They were on the same frequency which were we on our radio sets, and one of the Pakistani soldiers or officer, whosoever it was, he said to me, my code name was Sher Shah. Oh Sher Shah, you have come, don't try to come up, otherwise you'll have a tough time. And that was the time they gave us a challenge, and my guys, they went wild. How dare a Pakistani troop can challenge us?
Vikram's next operation on the 7th of July 1999 was his last. And what he personally managed to do helped send the Pakistani army into full retreat. In bloody hand-to-hand combat with Pak soldiers, Vikram charged, screaming, Durga Mata Ki Jai, his Jackriff regiment's war cry. Entering a stone fortification, he killed 5 Pakistani soldiers using his gun and bayonet, but ultimately perished when he was targeted by an enemy machine gun nest. Buoyed by his leadership, his soldiers attacked the Pakistani position with vengeance, capturing point 4875.
Most people think that we do not have to fight hand-to-hand fight now. But Kargil war, there was a lot of hand-to-hand fighting. It happened in point 4875 also. Many places, this kind of a thing.
I'll share a very personal incident. You know, when I was young, a school-going kid, I really used to get scared looking at a dead body. And you know, when the body was taken out of the coffin and the tricolor along with his cap was handed over to mom, I took the body out of the coffin and I hold it in my hands. And that was the first cremation ever in my life. Whatever fear I had for death,